Shalom, friends. It's been a week since the violent and racist KKK and Nazi rallies in Charlottesville, and we haven't seen the end of it, have we? There were more in Boston. There have been some in other cities across the country. There was an outbreak of neo-Nazis marching in Berlin, in Germany. And so the question that I want to bring to this week's Torah portion is, how are we supposed to respond when we see this kind of rage, this kind of violence, this kind of anger? People aren't just marching to express vile, unacceptable opinions. They are doing that, but they're bringing shields and they're bringing clubs and they're bringing weapons and they're bringing guns. The threat of violence is sometimes on the surface and sometimes just under the surface. And the intention, like all terrorism, is to try to cow us all into silence, to get us to crawl back into our homes, to get us to feel weak and surrounded, and to feel like they somehow can dictate the terms of our communities and our conversations. And in the light of that, I want to highlight what the Torah tells us. There's an amazing passage in the 20th chapter of the book of Deuteronomy speaking about when we are assaulted, when people wage war against us. And our first human response is to quiver in fear, to be able to try to shield ourselves or back away. But the Torah says that's not the right response. When evil shows its face, when enemies try to sweep away civilized conversation, human dignity, equality, these core biblical values of all of us being in God's image, then what are we supposed to do? Well, here comes the Torah's command unequivocally. Al tira'u ve'al tachbizu ve'al ta'artzu mipneichem. You may not let your courage falter. You may not be in fear. You may not panic. You may not act as though you are in dread of them. Of course, these feelings are natural, but those feelings can't stop us from rising to the challenge. Despots and terrorists thrive when good people allow their fear to make them back away. And so in the light of the Nazis and the KKK and the equivocation on the part of some officials to be able to simply and cleanly condemn racism, white supremacy, that kind of arrogant ethnic nationalism that is so corrosive and destructive to the kind of multiple community the Bible invites us to, a feast in which all are welcome to the table, we have to stand with God. We have to stand with biblical values. We have to stand with our brothers and sisters, Muslims, Buddhists, Hindus, atheists, Jews, Christians, white, black, brown, everybody. And we have to be able to do so with courage and with strength. So let's resolve together, brothers and sisters, from this week on, no Nazis in our presence. No bigots in our presence, no Klansmen in our presence, no racist comments, no jokes that disparage others, no subtle bigotry will pass while we stand here. The watchword is, don't be afraid, and don't let them make you back down. Shalom.